your hands up.
What the hell was that? Wanna die?
Somebody get an ambulance for Mom here.
Ori, submarine, extra jalapenos. Chicken sandwich, the hair on it.
It's not hair, Harry. It's alfalfa sprout.
Looks like hair, tastes like hair, so to me it's hair. Open sesame.
Yeah.
Get them while they're hot.
Good.
Starving. You're not the only one.
Holy cow.
Look at all this stuff. That's all from tonight?
I told you it was some haul. Oh, Harry, come on. They put the sauce on it. I told you, on the side.
I forgot to tell him. Big deal, you're gonna put the sauce on it anyway.
But the bread gets all soggy.
So sue me.
Wow.
Yeah, we tagged some of it. One of it was from a robbery 7 years ago.
And he never fenced any of it?
What can I say? You like to wear it. Gotta give him credit for good taste.
Yeah. And I'm glad my wife can't see any of this. Her zircon tennis bracelet wouldn't look too good next.
You forgot the fries.
They're on the bottom, under the napkins. This necklace, you ID'd it yet?
Uh-uh. Something, isn't it? If it's real.
No, it's real.
Well, what are you, a gemologist?
No. No, I've seen a picture of it. There wouldn't be two like this. Belonged to Martin Dunn's wife.
You're kidding. The Martin Dunn?
Yeah, maybe we can get a picture in the newspaper. I didn't get back to the old lady.
Yeah, you got the wrong Mrs. Dunn. Talking about his father's wife. She was shot to death the night of the robbery. They worked the case.
I don't remember even hearing about it.
Yeah, it's before your time.
If there's a murder case they can close the books on. This'd be great if the bread wasn't soggy.
Books have been closed. Martin Dunn was an eyewitness. Kid got life. No possibility of parole.
How long ago?
18 years.
Talking to myself and feeling old. Sometimes I'd like to quit. Nothing ever seems to fit. Hanging around, nothing to do but frown. Rainy days and Mondays always get me down.
You're set, you're up.
Sure, jam a lot of weight for a little guy.
I've had a lot of time to get in shape.
Hey! Warden wants to see you.
That'll be all, Eli. Have a seat, Hayes. You remember Attorney General Lindsay? Jeff? I'll make this brief. New evidence has turned up in your case. We have a complete confession of the stolen property from the Dunn murder case. The paperwork will take a couple of days, but I am sorry. I don't know what else to say. The eyewitness, the murder weapon. I wish I...
Do you mind waiting for us?
Sure bet. Take your time.
Thanks.
God, 18 years.
I tried not to party too much and abuse my body. How's your life now? Are you still married?
Yeah. We have two little girls now, 6 and 5.
That's nice. How's the boy? How's Carrie?
He's fine. He's a handsome boy. He just graduated from high school.
Have you ever told him the truth about me?
No. He still thinks his father was killed in an accident. Paul doesn't know either.
You didn't tell him.
I was afraid, Jeff. I mean, I know it sounds stupid, but I had a chance for a life again. A husband. Father for our son. I just couldn't tell him that Carrie's father was serving life for murder.
Well, I was innocent.
I know. But who was going to believe me? Your own father didn't believe you.
Yeah. Did you ever hear from him?
No. Not since the day you were arrested. You blamed Carrie and me for what happened, remember? You stole so you could get us the things we wanted.
Yeah, I remember. I stopped writing him years ago. Never got an answer. I even sent him some self-addressed envelopes.
You're gonna see him?
Yeah, if he's still alive, he's all I've got now.
You've got a son. You know the publicity this is gonna cause. I'm going to have to tell him now. I'm going to have to tell both of them.
Hey. Hey, come on. Oh. It's going to be okay. Everything's going to be okay. Your Paul's going to understand. Look, it was all my idea anyway. I told you it was just the same as being dead. We did what we thought was best for the boy.
You've been in prison 18 years and I'm the one crying on your shoulder.
Dad?
Hey,
What the hell are you doing that for? Well, from the time I was a kid, whenever anything happened that needed to be talked out, it was always the same thing. I can't talk now. I gotta polish my shoes. You gotta polish your damn shoes. Give me that!
I was in the bar, and they told me about it. They showed me the newspaper.
Dad, it's okay.
I didn't believe you.
It's okay, Dad.
That Dunn guy, Martin Dunn, he said it was you. Damn it, why the hell did he say it was you? Why didn't I believe you?
I don't know. Maybe you didn't know me, maybe. Maybe you're too busy polishing your shoes.
Oh, God.
I saw Ellen today. I can't even begin to explain what it was like after all these years. She was different and yet the same. I was so frightened. It was like a first date with someone you'd loved your whole life. She's going to tell Carrie the truth. God, I wonder what my son is like.
She's blown off.
So what? If you don't ask, you'll never know.
She's not gonna dance with me.
Oh, Robbo, come on. All she can say is no, that's not gonna kill you. Get some confidence, man.
Come on. All right, what the hell?
Hi, how you doing?
Want something?
Thank you. No. Gotta cool it. Had a couple. Gonna be driving.
Good idea. Those Shirley Temples really waste you.
That's funny. I'm Rob.
I'm very happy for you.
Hey, do you want to dance?
Yes. But not with you. Now, why don't you run along and annoy someone else? Don't tell me. You're homely and deaf, too. Go away.
Hey,
No. Damn, she just put me down. Listen, I think I'm just gonna take off, okay?
Come on. You gonna let her louse up your whole night?
Yeah, probably. It's me. It's just me.
What are you talking about?
I'm talking about me. I wouldn't dance with me either.
I would. But you never asked.
Shut up.
Come on. We'll have some fun tonight, huh?
All right, I'll stay for a little while. Order me another soda. I gotta take a leak.
Club soda and lemon.
Hi.
Hi.
I can't believe they don't carry Perrier. So, Vivian.
Carrie Hayes.
Crystal Parker.
Let's move a little.
I can't wait for Christmas break. I'm dying to go skiing. Do you ski?
A little, yeah.
Oh, where do you go?
Mammoth, usually.
Oh, local. What a shame. That's not really skiing. We go to Val d'Isère in France.
Oh, I thought snow was snow.
How plebeian. Anyone who's anyone skis in Europe. I rode up on a chairlift one year with Jean-Claude Keeley.
Oh, he makes those karate movies, doesn't he?
Please! He was an Olympic champion! He was so charming. If I hadn't been there with a former boyfriend, I don't know.
Whoa, we got trouble. Just do what I tell you.
What are you talking about?
Would you just shut up and do what I tell you? Be quiet and stay down. Say anything to anybody.
I don't say anything. I didn't see anything.
All right, get out.
Bravo! Got her, kid!
You should see that. Blood, man. She soaked her socks.
Yeah, I love it!
What are you doing up?
Waiting for you.
Oh, well, it's late. Maybe I can save you some time. No, I don't know what I want to do with my life. And no, I don't want to go to college. And since I said no to the two above, yes, I'll get a job and I will get out.
Paul never told you to get out. That was your idea.
Oh, Mom, come on.
When somebody tells you you have to do something with your life, you can't just expect to live at home. I mean, wouldn't you assume that that meant get a job and get out?
No, I wouldn't assume that. I'd assume that someone was trying to help
you. I don't want his help. Be honest. He doesn't want me around. He never has.
Listen to you. Why would he, the way you act?
I don't want to talk about this anymore.
Carrie, your father's alive.
What?
He wasn't killed. I lied to you.
What is this? What are you talking about?
It was in the paper today.
What do you mean, the paper? What was in the paper?
Why? Why didn't you ever tell me?
Carrie, I did what I thought was best.
Best? All this time I had a father, a real father, and you never told me? I can understand him not telling me, but you...
Paul didn't know either. I told him tonight. Carrie, maybe it was the wrong thing. Your father and I both thought it was the best thing. I just didn't want you to grow up with the thought of your father being in prison for the rest of his life. Can't you understand that?
I don't know what I understand. I don't know anything now.
Please talk to me, Carrie.
No, I can't. I can't.
Still here. Thought you went somewhere.
No, I slipped in. I was up kind of late last night.
Oh, yeah? What were you doing on the fire escape?
I slept out there. Forget how good fresh air smells.
Fresh air, it stinks. The smog, it stinks.
Believe me, stink is relative, Dad.
So you want a little breakfast?
I have some coffee, that's all.
Instant. I've just got instant.
That's okay.
Listen, I got some of the cinnamon bread. It's not bad. I like it. You want a piece?
Yeah, I'll try it.
I'll heat it up. It's better. Of course, you can't heat it too much, otherwise the icing melts and falls off.
Not easy, is it, Dad?
What?
Trying to talk to each other.
I better get this in the oven.
Oh, he wants you to hold mine. I think I'll take a shower first.
Jeff?
Yeah.
About last night. Well, I don't know what I said, but I don't drink that much anymore, you know? And, well, I got a little messed up.
Careful, your icing didn't melt in.
I'd like to get home by today. Mind telling me what you were thinking about?
Nothing.
Nothing. Yeah, that's a brilliant answer.
You asked me a question and I answered it. I mean, what's the big deal? All they got me for is reckless driving, a misdemeanor. So what?
What the hell is the matter with you? What do you think? The cops want to play cowboys and Indians with you? You're lucky they didn't blow your brains out. Oh, what's the use? It's like talking to a wall.
When do I get my car back?
You don't. I have been walking on eggshells with you ever since I met your mom. Well, maybe I was wrong. Maybe I didn't go about it the right way, but damn it, I tried.
I never asked you to try.
Oh, no. You never had any trouble asking for anything you wanted. Money, clothes, your car. Well, I'm tired, Carrie. I'm tired of pretending. I'm tired of bending over backwards just to keep peace with you. You're either going to get your act together or you're going to get out.
Fine. I'll get out.
Not this time, Carrie. Not this time.
Well, make the changes and I'll look at them tomorrow.
That's cutting it a little close. I could have this ready in 2 hours.
No, I'm leaving now. Tomorrow will be fine.
You got it.
Mrs. Kramer.
Yeah?
It's your secretary.
Oh. Yes?
I have Jeff Hayes on the line.
Okay, I'll take it. Hello.
Hi.
Jeff, I'm glad you caught me. I was just walking out the door. We had a problem with Carrie last night.
What happened?
Well, I'm not really sure. I told him about you and showed him the article, and he just ran out of the house. He was arrested.
For what?
I don't really know. Paul went down to get him out. Can I call you back later?
Yeah, sure. I'm at Dad's. 555-2476.
Okay, great. Fine. I'll call you.
Oh, Mr. Kramer is upstairs.
Oh, thank you. Carrie?
He's gone. Left about an hour ago.
What do you mean he's gone? Why didn't you stop him?
Because I didn't want to. I've put up with it and put up with it. I've listened to you make excuses for him. Well, no more.
Call the police.
And tell them what? That you have an 18-year-old son who's run away because he can't stand the fact that he's not the man of the house?
He's in an emotional state right now. Can't you understand that? He just found out that his father's alive.
Ellen, I just found out your husband's alive. What the hell? I'm not supposed to have feelings? You only feel pain when you're a teenager? Honey, what do we argue about most of the time in this house? Him. Him. And you know why? Because he likes it.
That's not true.
Yes, it is. You know it. He wants us to argue. He wants this family torn apart so he can take care of Mommy again. Ellen, I'm sorry. I love you. I love my family. I love my girls. But I just can't live in the same house with that boy. I'm sorry. I can't. You decide. He left you a note. It's on the dresser.
Hard shells. You used to love them.
Hey, sounds good.
Good. I'll throw down some newspapers and we'll have a great meal. Just like when you were a kid. Can't believe you're still banging away on that.
Yeah, I'm almost done. Just a couple of more pages.
Oh? What happens when you're finished?
I try to sell it.
Suppose it doesn't sell.
Hey, if it doesn't sell, it doesn't sell. I have to go out and look for a job anyway. Can't keep staying here. I gotta get my own place. Get out of your hair.
Yeah, well, it's no hurry. I mean, it doesn't bother me for a while, you know? I mean, rent's a murder these days. Look at the newspaper, you're not going to believe it. A lot of people are looking for roommates, you know, to share the rent. I even thought about it myself for a while because, you know, now that I'm retired. But it's tough trying to live with a stranger. Probably some guy with car trouble. I got a number that's one digit away from the 24-hour gas station. Those bums call me at 2 a.m. for a tow. Yeah? Oh, right, yeah, he's here. Oh, yeah, sure, yeah. Jeff, it's for you.
Hello?
Jeff?
What's happening with Carrie?
He's out. It was only a misdemeanor. Jeff, I need to talk to you. Could we meet tomorrow?
Sure. What's good for you?
See, I dropped the girls off at school at about 8:30. How about... that'll be just fine. I'll tell you what. Meet me at my office at about 9 o'clock and be sure and bring the proofs. Okay. Excuse me. 1 minute, please. Paul, could you get the girls ready for their bath? I promised them they could watch a movie tonight, but they have to be ready for bed. I couldn't even get them up this morning.
Okay. I'll get them ready.
Thanks. How about 9 o'clock tomorrow in the park?
I'll be there. Hey, are you all right?
I can't talk now. I'll talk to you tomorrow. Bye.
You ready to eat?
Yeah. I'll just wash up.
What's she calling here for?
What?
What's she calling here for? It's over. It's been over. You gotta get on with your life.
What are you talking about? She's having a problem with our boy.
He's not your kid.
What do you mean he's not my kid? She had to tell him the truth now. He knows he's got a father. He's my kid.
She raised him. If he's got a problem, it's her fault. Look, you're just getting started again, Jeff. What do you need our problem
for? Look,
just
drop it, Dad. I don't want to talk to you about it.
Oh, sure. Don't listen to your father. What the hell does he know? If you didn't listen to me in the first place, you wouldn't have screwed up your life.
All right, that's it. I'm out of here.
Oh, sure. Run away. Just like when you were a kid.
I didn't run away when I was a kid, Dad. You drove me away. There's a difference, you know?
I drove you away? I tried to give you good advice. Is that driving you away? You could have gone to college, Jeff. You had the grades. But no, not you. You get a girl pregnant, you gotta marry her.
I married Ellen because I loved her. I'd have married her if she couldn't have a kid. What the hell am I doing this for? We had the same stupid argument 19 years ago. 19 years and nothing changes with you.
Oh, and with you, something changes, huh? She's gonna dump that kid on your problems and all. You'll see.
Dumping the kid on me, huh? You know what books I used to read when I was in prison, Dad? Books about raising kids. And from year one. But how you hold them and look at them and how quick they get to know you.
and the terrible twos and the potty training and the first days in school, about the joys and the fears. Then I used to lie in my bunk at night and try to get myself to dream I was doing those things with my kid. Teaching him to swim and how to throw a ball. And you know what, Dad? In my dreams, my kid loved me. Just the same as I love him and his mom.
I'm alone in town, and I wondered if you wanted to have dinner.
Sure. Want to hear the menu?
I'm serious. You want to have dinner or not?
What are you? One of those religious groups come to save me?
Never mind.
Dinner?
Yeah, I was serious.
You buying?
I asked you, didn't I?
Yeah. Can I pick the place?
Yeah, you can pick the place.
Cocktail before dinner?
Yeah, how about you?
I'll have a bourbon and beer.
Just beer for me.
What kind of beer would you like?
I don't care.
Me neither.
Very good.
Liz. My name, it's Liz.
Jeez, I'm sorry. I'm Jeff.
Jeff. Well, you already know what I do. What about you?
I guess you could say I'm a would-be writer.
No kidding, a writer.
Well, would-be. I haven't sold anything yet. I'm working on that now.
So is that why you wanted to take me to dinner? Like, get some background for a book or something?
No.
Then why?
Simple truth.
Best kind.
I didn't want to be alone.
Here we go. I'll be back in a minute to take your order.
To not being alone.
To not being alone.
I'm gonna go to the little girl's room. If the waiter comes back, would you order me the, house salad and spaghetti with meat sauce.
You got it.
I am really getting fed up with the way he does my hair. First it's too brassy, now it's too dull.
Try somebody else.
I'm afraid to. Did you see poor Lynn at brunch the other day? She went to someone new. They absolutely ruined her.
Excuse me.
I thought she looked different.
Yeah, her ends are splitting and the gray's coming through.
Well, I'll just have to see if I can find somebody I can trust. Sorry, it took so long.
The waiter already brought your spaghetti. If it's too cold, I can send it back.
No, it's fine. I like to eat the salad at the same time anyway.
Me too.
What?
You look different.
Boy, a man who notices. I wiped off some of the gunk. It's my night off. I thought I'd look more ladylike. I'm starving. That was ladylike, wasn't it? And one night, Ma was out playing bingo, and he tried it. Boy, did I throw up that night. I didn't tell Ma the first time, and he tried it again. And he got rough that time, so I told her. Anyway, she told him. He denied it. She screamed, I was a damn liar. And I was making it all up because I was jealous. So she kicked me out. I was 16. 16. Seems like 100 years ago.
You ever see her, talk to her?
Oh, I've called a few times. It was a bad scene. She said she couldn't forgive me. I mean, why the hell couldn't she believe? I was a kid, you know what I mean?
Yeah, I know what you mean.
I haven't talked to her in years.
Maybe you ought to try. People change, they mellow out.
Yeah, I thought about it. But I don't want her to know what I've been doing, and I've got this feeling she'd know. I mean, I wouldn't tell her, but she'd know. Well, you're in luck. This is it. You must be feeling like Dear Abby about now.
I had a good time.
Yeah, me too. Can you come out for a minute? Just a minute. I mean, no messing around or nothing. I just want to give you something. Please?
Okay.
Okay.
This will just take a minute. Place is a mess, I know. Don't say nothing. I went expecting company. And I don't want you to look while I do this. It's really great, though. Wait till you see. Okay, don't look. Thing's amazing. I'm almost done. Here. It's dumb, huh? I just thought you could carry it, you know, like a remembrance. You think it's dumb, don't you?
No. No, I don't think it's dumb. I think it's nice.
I got one, too. So I won't forget either. It'll, like, remind me I got a friend.
Everybody needs someone who cares about them. There's nothing worse than being alone. Now, if I'm feeling lonely, I'll look at my matchbook and say, hey, I got somebody. I got a friend, Jeff. You gotta go, don't you?
Forget something?
No, I wanted to talk to you. Can I come in?
Suit yourself. You picked a bad time. I'm kind of busy.
Dad, it's 12:30 at night. Now, that's a bad time to talk, but a great time to vacuum the rug, huh?
We said everything we had to say to each other tonight. You made it pretty clear. You don't want to be around me? That's fine.
Look, will you stop for a minute and listen?
No, you listen. This is my place, and if I want to clean it in the middle of the night, that is my business.
You're always cleaning this place. You could eat off the floor in here.
Oh, and I suppose that's another thing you want to argue about. I guess there's something wrong in your opinion about wanting to keep a place neat.
You clean it all the time because you got nothing else to do.
What? What the hell are you talking about?
Who are your friends, then?
I've got lots of friends.
Well, who are they? Give me the list.
That's my business. Look, I don't want to argue anymore.
No, of course you don't. You're not used to it. You don't even have anybody to argue with.
Oh, boy, the kid knows everything.
Oh, come on. Who's called you since I've been here, Dad? Huh? Who's called you on the phone? Some guy looking for a 24-hour gas station. Come on, let me see your phone bill. I guarantee AT&T isn't making a nickel on your message units. Oh, Dad, there's so many lonely people out there. So many people who don't have anybody for one reason or another. We don't have to be like that. We're family. Look, it doesn't mean we have to get along all the time. Nobody does. We don't even have to like each other all the time. Bottom line is, I don't want to be alone. Do you? Hello. Yeah, hold on a second. It's for you.
Hello? damn it, I'm not giving you a tow. You got the wrong number. You got room for some of those hard shells? I'm just gonna stick up my fridge. He's on the counter.
Oh, thanks, Dad.
What are you doing today?
Well, I'm gonna have some copies made up of my manuscript. I'm gonna go out and look for some work.
Anything in mind?
I don't know. I was thinking about going back to driving a cab. After all those years in prison, the idea of working inside just doesn't seem to appeal to me.
Hacking ain't what it used to be. That's why I retired early. Those druggies will shoot you for $5.
Maybe we ought to get a tow truck. Business is booming. Hello, this is No Tow. You got the wrong number. Yeah, that's me. Who? Yeah, how did you find me? Yeah, I bet you do. I don't know. Look, give me your number. I'll call you later when I find out what my schedule's like. All right, I got it. I will. Goodbye.
Who was that?
Martin Dunn II.
That bastard's kid? What did he want?
He wouldn't say. He just wanted to talk.
Probably afraid you're going to sue his old man or something.
Who knows? Hey, look, I got to run. You got a car I can borrow?
Yeah, I got the car, but you haven't driven in a while.
Dad, I can drive a car. It's like swimming. You don't forget how to do it.
You sure?
I'm sure.
Hey, listen, it's in the back. Third slot from the corner, yellow Plymouth.
They used to have a yellow Plymouth a long time ago.
Same yellow Plymouth.
I bet you could eat off the floor of your car, too.
I'll see you later, Dad.
Jeff. Sure, I shouldn't drive you. I mean, you could get in trouble. You don't have a license.
Dad, I just spent 18 years in prison for something I didn't do. I think I can handle a driving without a license charge. I'll see you. He's got a lot of anger in him. Did you say Paul really tried with him, though?
Anything too hard. We both have. Should have been tougher.
Well, we're in the same boat. He doesn't want to see you and doesn't want to see me. He's going through a lot of stuff. What about his friends? Anybody he might be staying with?
Here I wrote down a list of all his friends.
All right, I'll check him out.
I just want to know he's okay.
I know.
Oh. And here's his picture. Graduation.
What a handsome kid, huh?
He's got your eyes.
Well, maybe it's a little bit of both of us. I can't believe it. We made that kid. You know, when I was in prison, it seemed so long ago. Now it's just like yesterday. Remember our wedding night when I got lost? I couldn't find a hotel.
I had morning sickness. You kept having to pull over in the car so I could throw up. Real romantic.
But I'll check all this stuff out. I gotta go. I've got an appointment. Don't worry about him. He'll probably call you before I find him. And remember, he's 18. He's a big boy. Come on, I'll walk you to the car.
help you?
Yeah, I'm here to see Mr. Dunn, Jeff Hayes.
Oh, yes. Mr. Hayes is here. He'll be right with you.
Thank you.
Mr. Hayes? Right this way. Mr. Hayes is here, sir.
Thank you, Ev. Hold my calls.
Yes, sir.
Please, have a seat. Well, first of all, I want to thank you for coming. I'm not sure if the situation were reversed, I'd want to sit in the same room with someone named Dunn. I'm not sure if you are aware of it, but my father passed away a little over a year ago.
No, I didn't know.
If you were alive today, I'm not sure what he'd say to you. But try and understand what my mother's death did to him. And they were inseparable. They had that kind of relationship that we all dream about, but very few of us find. I'm telling you all this in an effort to explain why my father identified you.
You don't have to.
No, please. My father wanted someone to pay for his pain, for his incredible loss. God, so did I. After the gun was traced to you, he was sure. But he was afraid he wouldn't be able to identify you in the lineup. And if he didn't, then the case against you could go either way. And so he used his influence, and he had lots of it, to obtain a photograph of you before the lineup. And in so doing, he stole 18 years of your life. I knew what my father had done. So I'm as responsible, I'm as guilty. I can't change what's happened. I can't give you back those years, but I'd like a chance to try to... God, I don't even know what words to use to try and make up for it in some small measure.
So what do you want to do? You want to, pay me X amount of dollars for every day I spent in prison? Pay me off? He's the old conscience, huh? No, thanks, Mr. Dunn.
Damn it, hear me out. I didn't have to tell you all this, you know.
Oh, sure you did. It's confession time. Three Hail Marys and life goes on. Keep your money.
I wasn't going to offer you money. I was going to offer you a job. Doing what you want to do, writing.
How do you know?
I contacted the prison. I found out what I could. They said you were writing a book.
Oh, so you want to pay for vanity press sight unseen?
No. I've been wanting to do a column for my Sunday section. Sort of like Charles Carroll's On the Road. A look at this country, its people, the good, the bad, the way it's changed over the years. And I thought, what better person to do it than someone who hasn't seen it in 18 years? A fresh look, a fresh approach. And yes, a chance to make up in some small measure.
How do you know I'm any good?
Let me see your manuscript. Let me read it.
Give me a call. And don't do me any favors. I don't forgive you or your father.
Stupid. I shouldn't have squeezed it. It looks worse. All right, better. Yeah, babe, I can throw back a few. Had some laughs. So what's your name, honey? Donna. I'm Rob. Rob Lowe.
Robbo. What are you doing?
Nothing. Do nothing.
Well, why don't you do nothing in the car so we can get going?
Did you take another beer? My dad's gonna notice they're missing.
Oh, come on. He's not.
No, he will. He counts them. Believe me.
So we'll pick up some more. We got ID. Now let's go.
Do you really think these IDs are gonna work?
You could hand that license to a cop and he wouldn't know.
Oh! Bravo, let's go! I'm coming! Coming!
I love you. Yeah. Oh, Pippa.
Go get her, Arnold.
Please don't smoke.
What?
You're too beautiful to smoke. They'll turn your teeth all yellow and you'll cough up dirty phlegm every morning and you'll die before your time. Do you realize that lung cancer among young, extremely beautiful women is up 20% in the last 10 years? So please, from an admirer, don't put another filthy cigarette into those lips.
They're not for me.
Oh. Well, at least you have to admit it was a different opening line.
It sure was.
Can I buy you a drink?
No.
Dance a dance?
I'm with someone.
You want something?
Are those for him? Have a good time.
Here's your cigarettes.
What was he saying to you?
Nothing. He didn't say anything. Just go back and sit down.
I want to know what he said.
I told you nothing. Every time you get drunk, you get mad at nothing.
Hey, I'll decide what's nothing.
You're acting like a jerk.
Hey, you. I wasn't done talking to you.
Hey, look, I don't want any trouble.
Yeah? Well, it's too late now. You already got trouble. I don't know what you said to my girl.
I didn't say anything out of line, all right? Look, let's just forget it.
I'm not done with you. Now, you're gonna tell me what you said, or I'm gonna kick some butt.
He said he didn't say anything. Why don't you leave him alone? Go have a good time.
Who the hell's talking to you? It's between me and the big mouth kid.
That's right, he's a kid, so why don't you leave him alone?
You want some of what I'm gonna give him?
Why not?
Thanks.
Guess some guys shouldn't drink.
Yeah.
Especially if they're underage.
Hey, I'm not underage. What are you, a cop or something? I got ID right here.
Date's right, the year's wrong.
What are you talking about?
You were born in 73, not 70.
Oh, yeah, you bet.
Born December 6th at 9:30 in the morning at Presbyterian Hospital. I'm your father, Carrie. How would you say adios to your friend Robbo when you and I go somewhere and talk? All right, let's say they didn't catch this guy and I spend the rest of my life in prison. Are you trying to tell me that you would have been better off spending the fourth Saturday of every month talking to me through a pane of glass?
At least I would have known you. I would have come. I would have come every Saturday.
Yeah, well, maybe I didn't want you to come, okay? Same as I didn't want your mother coming anymore. Hey, you know what it's like in there? It's like dying. It's like spending your life dying. And then once a month, the people that you love have to come and watch you die. Well, I didn't want that. I made the decision. I didn't want it anymore. Can't you understand that?
When Mom told me about you, I got so angry. I don't know. It was like, well, Paul didn't want me. And then I find out I have a real father, and he didn't want me.
So you wrote a rotten letter and took off. It was a lousy thing to do to your mom. She deserves better than that. She took care of you alone for a lot of years.
She should have stayed alone. She shouldn't have married him. We were getting along fine.
Oh, no, you were getting along fine. What, your mother doesn't have a life?
We had a life. A good life. I took care of
her. Oh, come on. Oh, you were the man of the house, huh?
I was, till she met him.
And what happens when you move out? What happens when you move out, you get married, you got a family of your own? What happens to your mother then? Come on, what happens to her? What, maybe she gets lucky, gets to visit you the fourth Saturday of every month? Come on, kid, it's time for you to start thinking of somebody besides yourself. Now, come on, I'm taking you home.
I'm not going back.
Hey, look, this isn't Paul you're talking to. I don't want to be your buddy. I don't want to be your pal. I'm your father, and you're going to do what I tell you because I spent 18 years of my life loving a kid I never... Get in the car. Get in the car.
Water. I don't want to see either one of you up again tonight. It's the middle of the night, and you have school in the morning. Now, I'm not going to let you do this anymore if the two of you keep staying awake all night.
It wasn't me. It was Shauna. She was the one.
Nuh-uh. She told me to say I was thirsty.
I don't care which one of you it was. Now, if I see either one of you out of bed, you're both going to be in trouble. Now, here.
I want my own glass.
Shauna, honey, I'm very tired. Would you please just take a sip or lie down?
What's wrong with Daddy?
Nothing, sweetie.
Yes, there is.
Maybe he's just tired. I know I'm certainly very tired, and you should be tired. Now, I want you both to go to bed right now.
Can we have the bathroom light on?
Honey, I left the light on in the hallway.
Please?
Will you go right to sleep then?
Yes.
Okay.
It's close too far.
That's just fine. Now go to sleep. And no talking. Maybe they'll sleep this time. Want to watch the news?
Not really.
Paul, what is it?
Nothing.
Oh, come on. Even the girls sensed it. That's why they're not sleeping. I'm gonna go make some tea. You want anything?
Were you late for work this morning?
No, why?
I just wondered. You know how traffic is.
It was really fun.
Yeah, it was. In fact, I got to town so early I had time to relax. In the park.
Paul, I only went there...
Because I know why you went there. You went to see him. I mean, why not? After all, he's the man you've been in love with all these years, isn't he?
No, that's not why I went there. I went there...
Isn't? If he hadn't gone to jail, you'd still be married to him, wouldn't you? You loved him enough to lie to me about him, to tell me he was dead. Why, were you afraid I was going to ask you if you still loved him and you'd have to tell me yes? You still love him, don't you? Don't you?
Yes! He's the father of my child. Of course I still have feelings for him. But it's not the way you think. I went to the park to talk to Jeff about Carrie.
Oh!
To ask if he could see if the boy was all right.
You went to talk about Carrie?
Yes, Carrie.
Then why didn't you tell me?
Because I was afraid you'd start imagining the very things you're imagining right now.
My dad said you were worried. He brought me home.
It's 3 o'clock in the morning, Dad. What are you doing out here?
Oh, I was just taking a walk. You know, stretching the legs.
Oh. Yeah, well, it's a nice night. You ought to try walking a little further than your parking space. The car's fine, Dad. Not a scratch on it.
Hey, I wasn't worried.
Of course not. Didn't find any scratches in the car, did you?
For your information, I wasn't looking for any. I was locking up the car. So, want a snack or something?
You having one?
Yeah. Microwave some cinnamon bread off of vanilla ice cream. It's good, believe me.
Yeah, I'll give it a try.
So, what happened? You talked to that guy at the newspaper, Dunn?
Yeah. Matter of fact, he offered me a job writing.
No kidding.
I haven't taken the job yet.
What do you mean you haven't taken the job? You're going to take the job, right?
Yeah, I'm thinking about it.
No wonder you're late. What did you do, go out and celebrate?
No, I was with Carrie. I told him I'd call him tomorrow. He'd like to see you. I thought maybe we could take him out to dinner if it's all right with you. Dad?
If that's what you want.
Don't give me too much ice cream. I'm really not that hungry.
She must have hit the streets again right after you left her. Same M.O. as the others. Could be a nice pick or a Phillips. It's the same guy, no doubt about that. In a way, you were lucky to be in jail when the others got it. You'd have been a prime suspect.
I shouldn't have left her.
We got a hold of her mother. She identified the body, but she didn't want to claim it. Said she was nothing but a whore. Didn't deserve a decent burial. Dear. People can be cold.
Can I marry her?
You sure you want to do that?
Yeah, she was my friend.
It's all right. Send him up.
Yeah, I'm sorry to come by without calling first, but I wonder if you'd read my stuff.
Yes, I have. I was going to call you today. I like it.
Job still offered.
You bet it is.
I'll take it. Next question, can I have an advance?
Certainly. Just let my secretary know the amount.
Well, I have to make the arrangements first, then I'll call her. I'm not too sure how much things cost anymore.
But we should sit down, work out a contract. Salary, expenses, you're gonna be traveling a lot, you'll need transportation.
All right, we can do that in a couple of days, okay?
Okay.
I'll see you in a couple of days.
Secretary called. It's not an appointment.
Yeah, I took the job in the newspaper.
I don't believe it. Hey, that's just great. You know, the first thing we should do is get a bigger place. How much are they paying?
I don't even know yet, Dad.
Well, whatever. It's got to be pretty good. Now, look, I spoke to the landlord. They got a two-bedroom that's being freed up at the end of the month. I'll go talk to her and tell her to hold it. I'll put down a deposit.
Hey, hold it, Dad.
What? Hold it. You can't keep sleeping on that sofa or on the fire
escape. Dad, it's traveling. The job is traveling. I'm moving around the country. I'm on the road.
Oh, I thought, you know, up with the newspaper that it'd be local stuff. I didn't know. What about the boy? Does he know you'll be leaving?
No, I haven't told him yet. He's out of school. He doesn't have any plans. I was thinking about asking him to go with me.
On the road. That's good. That's good. I mean, give you two a chance to really get to know each other, you know? That's good. Oh, boy. I'm almost out of vanilla ice cream. Look, I'll be back. I gotta go to the store.
Dad.
I'll be back.
Carrie?
Yeah, Dad.
Yeah, kid, how you doing? I did.
Oh. Must have downed it off.
Let me ask you something.
Yeah, what?
You want to go with us?
What do you mean?
I mean, do you want to go on the road with Carrie and I?
Oh, come on. What are you talking about? That's crazy.
What's crazy about it?
You got your hands full with the kid. You don't need your old man tagging along.
Dad, I want you to go.
No, you don't. You're just doing it to be nice. Well, thanks, but no thanks. I do fine by myself.
Come on, Dad. Why do you always have to be so stubborn?
I'm not being stubborn. I got a life, too, you know. I got my place here. I can't just leave.
Why? You don't own it. You just rent it.
I've got all my things.
Dad, what things? You don't even own the furniture. All you got's a plant, so take the plant with you. Oh, come on. It's a chance for us to be together. Chance for you to get to know your grandson.
You keep calling him my grandson. I don't even know the kid. We probably won't even get along. I mean, kids that age, they have no time for old people. Look, you're the one who wants to be with them, so be with them.
Will you at least go to dinner with us?
Yeah, if you'll just stop talking so I can get ready.
Dad.
What?
Come on.
I shouldn't have come tonight. I don't know why I'm here.
Hey, Dad. It's getting late. Didn't think you were coming.
Carrie, this is your grandfather.
Hi, Grandfather.